There are three vows every nun must accept. The vow of poverty, the vow of obedience, and the vow of chastity.
I'm out of here with that. Oh, man.
One kid once said to me, he said, were you really a cat? And I heard myself say, just pull yourself together. How could I have been?
Anyway. Silence! The House of Godric Gryffindor has commanded the respect of the wizard world for nearly 10 centuries. I will not have you in the course of a single evening besmirching that name by behaving like a babbling, bumbling band of baboons.
I'm going to say something very rude to you. Fuck you.
Asked. We're going to work forever if we're asked.
Jane. But you're always asked first, if I may say so. I'm turning on you now. It's all coming out now.
One of my hearing aids has gone. What have we just
done? Do you want one of mine? What? Do you want one of mine?
I know it won't fit. It's just what was the last thing said.
Are we going to go on working forever, Joan?
Oh, was that it?
And I said Jude gets all the parts first.
Oh, no. Yeah. I tell you, my agent in America said to me when he knew I couldn't do very much because of the eyesight going, and he said, well, if you do want to come over again, we'll look around for a nice little cameo that Judi Dench hasn't got her paws on.
How rude.
It's not rude at all.
It's very, very rude.
Well, we say American, darling, that's how they talk.
I would like Maud to see your father as the son she never had.
Will she be the mother I never had?
Sarcasm is the lowest form of wit.
I don't understand. Why would anybody want to steal a dead, naked body?
Well, dear, there are people who...
Oh, that's tacky. That's really tacky.
I'm not one to use hyperbole, ladies and gentlemen, but I'll tell you this. For the first time in my life, I had the cucker scared out of me.
I like her. I really like her.
So are you, in a way, sort of glad that Downton's over?
Oh, yeah.
No, I really am.
No, because, honestly, she was about... By the time we finished, she must have been 110. So I couldn't go on and on and on. Listen and learn, son. Tea is a herb that's been dried out. So to bring it back to life, you have to infuse it in boiling water. That is boiling water. Everywhere I've been in this country, they slap down a cup of tepid nonsense, you know, with the tea bag lying beside it, which means I've got to go through the ridiculous business of dunking it in the lukewarm piss, waiting for the slightest change of colour to occur. And at my age, I haven't got the time.
This is what I'm talking about.
We're both very old. Thanks.
Then let's get married.
What do you mean a man's opened a colony in Essex?
Not that sort of colony, Mama. It's for people who want to take all their clothes off.
In Essex? Isn't it terribly damp?
Would that make a difference?
Well, yes, if you had no clothes on. Well, I think it's a mad idea.
This is Sir Thomas Beecham. He was one of Britain's greatest conductors.
Yes, I know who he was. He inherited a fortune. His grandfather made laxatives, naming a nursing home after him is frighteningly apt.
Girl groups? Boogie-woogie on the piano? What were you thinking?
I was thinking more like Vegas, you know, get some butts in the seats.
And what next? Popcorn? Curtain calls? This is not a theatre or a casino.
Yeah, but that's the problem, see? People like going to theaters and they like going to casinos, but they don't like coming to church. Why? Because it's a drag. But we could change all that. See, we could pack this joint.
Through blasphemy? You have corrupted the entire choir.
Oh, hello. Are you feeling better? Are you hungry?
Mm-hmm. Oh, Ursula, stop it. You look like a cannibal. Kommen aus Polen.
Aus Polen? Yeah.
Yeah, I told you.
Was ist dein Name?
Marowski. Andrea.
Andrea Marovsky?
Yeah.
Ich, Miss Weddington. Und das ist mein Schwester.
Ursula.
Ursula.
Say the line.
And she says, oh, that's a rotten part. And has to say to the other guy, oh, I assure you, Rose, this artist to artist, that part is absolutely rotten. But I mean, that's... I mean, you remember that because it's sort of very... I suppose it's a very vivid way of doing it.
But that, on the
that
page...
That is something that... I mean, that's very much something that Ken taught me.
Oh, really?
In actual fact. In the Schaffer play. Well, I had a very long speech in the Schaffer... Well, everybody has a long speech in a Schaffer play. That, you know, he does write long speeches for actors. This was an endless speech, it seemed to me. And it did sound endless, I must say. And Ken, eventually, one day, in that awful office at the Queen's Theatre, said, look, Ducky. Awful day. He said, you know, you're being absolutely boring.
A full-length shift was seen. A garment the colour of the whoring of which he had been accused. The colour of martyrdom and defiance. Blood. Red. Oh.
But if, baby, I'm the bottom, you're the top.
There's nothing simpler than avoiding people you don't like. Avoiding one's friends, that's the real test.
The people coming up to you now, like, because apparently Americans are very, well, you know, they're not shy Americans.
No. But I don't go anywhere, really, where they can get at me. It's usually in museums and art galleries and things, so that limits things. I keep away from there, and Harrods I don't go near.
Take the A sound, make it an I sound. Take the O sound, make it an A.
Only the hurdling and the hopping over the IH is what irks the horses' hooves.
It's the emerald.